John Horgan and Andrew Weaver both in attendance of a pro-proportional representation rally on Sunday. But the person at the rally really getting some attention is this guy.
You may as well make an informed decision on question two.
How can you see?
Oh, what was that? Yeah, in order to combat the inherent boringness of explaining election systems, I'm going to sprinkle in some fun shit, like me failing as a parent.
He's trying to make learning about the referendum a little more exciting for, well, everyone. And he's doing it through four homemade videos featuring his toddler and a sombrero-wearing Pomeranian.
I'm worried that Elections BC and the Vote Yes campaign haven't found a really fun and interesting way to break this down. And the Vote No campaign just keeps pushing this narrative that you're too dumb to understand it. Great campaign, guys.
Joel McCarthy's videos on proportional representation have gone viral, with nearly a million views online. And it all started out with him and his politically minded friends' fears that people would have no idea what they were voting for in the referendum.
So we got together, put a white bed sheet against the wall, researched for hours, read the entire Governor General's report, everything, and created a 5-minute video that really encapsulated this election.
McCarthy came out to the pro-rep rally on Sunday with his son, who makes more than a few guest appearances in the videos.
Oh, are you okay? Mixed member proportional.
At the rally, Premier John Horgan and BC Green Party leader Andrew Weaver accompanied supporters to a mailbox to mail referendum ballots in.
What better outcome could we give our children and our grandchildren and their children than an electoral system that allows them to have a government that reflects the diversity of views in our community every single time, not just once every 150 years? Wouldn't that be something?
Those on the Vote No side of pro-rep say they are particularly concerned with the possibility of extremists being voted into the legislature.
My father lived through the Nazi occupation of Holland. He joined the Dutch resistance. And the idea that neo-Nazis, that extremist right-wing parties, could enter the BC legislature simply because they got 5% of the vote is absolutely outrageous to me.
The deadline for voting in the referendum is November 30th, but there have been calls to extend the voting time period due to the Canada Post strike and low voting return numbers. In Vancouver, Ashley Burr, City News.